I'm so glad we could all be together for Thanksgiving this year. Emily, we're especially glad to finally meet you. Sam has been gushing about you nonstop since you two started dating.
You finally have a doctor in the family, Mom. Emily's almost done with med school. She's been working at a vaccine clinic in the city as part of her residency.
How wonderful. I just got my flu shot last week. I just wish I could convince Sam's dad to do the same.
I'm sure you're doing good work, Emily. I'm just not convinced that vaccines are safe. How do they even come up with those things?
I totally understand your concern, Mr. Rose, but a lot of work goes into making sure vaccines are safe and effective. I can tell you a little bit about how they're made if you're interested. I don't want to bore everyone.
I'd love to hear from an expert source, Emily. We've got a lot of turkey to get through here. Please, go ahead.
Well, first, scientists choose which illness-causing virus or bacteria to target with a vaccine. Some viruses aren't good targets because of the way they interact with the immune system. Others are too rare or don't cause sickness serious enough to need a vaccine.
Is that why there's no vaccine for HIV? Because of the way it affects the immune system?
Exactly. Although scientists are working on an HIV vaccine, HIV just isn't an easy target. Once a vaccine target has been chosen, the exploratory phase begins. During this phase, researchers study the way the virus or bacteria affects the immune system. The goal is to create an imitation invader that teaches our bodies how to fend off the virus or bacteria. That way, our immune system knows what to do when it comes across the real thing. Once the vaccine is finally developed, preclinical testing can start. During this phase, the vaccine is tested in a few different ways that don't involve people. Unfortunately, not many vaccines make it past preclinical testing because they don't activate the immune system the way they should.
If a vaccine does show potential, what happens next?
The next step is getting approval for clinical testing from the FDA. This happens in three phases. During the first phase of clinical testing, small groups of people receive the trial vaccine. During the second phase, the study is expanded to include people who share things in common, like age and health, with the people the vaccine is intended for. During the third phase, the vaccine is given to thousands of people to make sure it's safe and effective.
How do they make sure a vaccine will work for everyone?
Well, clinical trials try to include a lot of different types of people to make sure the vaccine works well for everyone without dangerous side effects. Once a vaccine is finally approved, that's when it gets mass-produced and distributed to doctors' offices, pharmacies, and public health clinics across the country.
That's the part that worries me. How do we know a vaccine is safe when it's never been used before?
I hear you, and I think it's natural to worry about something brand new. But vaccines are based on years and years of research, and a vaccine is never approved by the FDA unless it's proven to be safe and effective.
I must say, you've made a convincing case for vaccines, Emily. I have to confess, I didn't know half of what you just told us.
Most people don't, and there's a lot of misinformation about vaccines out there. That's why I'm always willing to talk about them, at least until it's time for dessert.
Speaking of which, who wants some pumpkin pie?
Want to make sure you and your loved ones are up to date on vaccines? Your healthcare provider, pharmacist, or local health department can help. You can also visit the CDC website to learn more about vaccines and vaccine schedules. For more information, please visit healthywomen.org.